Hey guys, it's John from John's DIY Playground. This is part three of a series about the Moteino. In the first part, we talked to you about the different types of Moteinos. In the second one, we showed you how to put it together and solder. In this third one, we're going to show you how to control an external LED from your home automation gateway via an internet website. And you can measure this light level too, and we'll be sending that back and forth to and from our gateway. I'll show you how to do all that in this video, so stay tuned.
Here's a block diagram of what we're building today. We're really focusing on this first box here, which is a Moteino with the RFM69 transceiver, an external LED that we'll be controlling, and a photoresistor that'll report the light levels in the room. There's also the onboard LED at pin D9, which is over here on the Moteino in the upper right corner of it. That will talk wirelessly to this Moteino USB, which is going to be also a transceiver. It's a slightly different looking Moteino because it has the USB and FTDI chip built onto it. So we use a micro USB to USB cable to plug it in physically by wire to the Raspberry Pi and the Moteino USB. I won't go over that today on how to set that up, but I do have a separate video out there called Home Automation Gateway Setup and Node Test that I'll link to in the description below if you want more details on how to do that. Then finally, we have our laptop or any kind of desktop computer. You turn on the internet browser and point it at the IP address of the Raspberry Pi on your network, which will have a web server software running that'll display the different statuses of what's going on with this remote node over the air. And we'll show that in the demonstration at the end of this video. Alright guys, for our example, we need two bits of code. The first is the code that we're going to write to our Moteino, which is shown here. I'm on the CodeBender website. The second piece we'll go over next is going to be a code that we have to modify in the metrics.js file in our home automation server, but we'll get to that in a moment. A copy of this code will be on my GitHub site at John's DIY Playground. I'll make a link to it below the video also, but basically code right now is about 195 lines long, but I tried to comment it as much as possible, as you can see. I won't say too much about it since there's so much commenting in it, but really these are some of the standard setup things you need for a Moteino to talk to a gateway or a Moteino USB that I have sitting on my Raspberry Pi. It includes settings for what type of radio you have, the frequency of it, what the encryption keys are. Those have to all match identically. The network IDs all have to be the same for every single node in your home automation network, and so on. So my primary devices that I'm configuring here are for the onboard LED that's built into the Moteino. It's on pin 9. I can't change that. Our photoresistor, we're going to tie to A5, and we're going to give it power from A2 and just set A2 as high to feed it that power. And then our external LED is on digital pin 3. Now, really important thing, guys, is pay attention to pinouts of Moteino because it has that radio transceiver and a flash chip for over-the-air reprogramming. It uses a lot of existing pins that you might think are available, but they're not. So do not try to use digital 2, 8, 10, 11, 12, and 13 whenever you're designing a sketch with your Moteino. Next, for the flash circuit, we're going to be flashing it every second, so I'm just going to set the blink time as 1,000, which 1,000 milliseconds is 1 second. Checking our photoresistor, we're going to do that every 30 seconds, so that's what I do on this line here. We're not using delay functions, we're using timers and using the millis command to check against these moments in time. So they're not exactly precisely 30 seconds apart, but let's say it's very, very close to 30 seconds apart and the flash time is very, very close to 1 second apart. Setups, pretty standard, just like Arduino. You need to tell it pin modes if they're inputs or outputs. This is a section, the setup of course is only run through one time. We're initializing our radio, we're checking for if we have the E2 flash chip on our Moteino. And then finally into the loop section. Loop section's not really that big. There's just a couple of subroutines, let's say, in here. The first is checking for radio receiving of a message. So this is where we look for our incoming messages. I'm using a message of L0F for turning the external LED off. And I'm using LOF and LON, not a zero. Make sure you use an O. Again, this code will be on GitHub, so you hopefully can't mess that up. And then turning the blinking onboard LED on and off again. We're not using delay, we're just using millis to check against the last time we blinked and then deciding if we're going to turn on or off. And same with the photoresistor check. And next I'll show you how to set up the metrics.js file in your Raspberry Pi so that it knows how to interpret these messages and how to send that LOF and LON commands to the Moteino back and forth. Now on to the second of the files that we need to modify or have available. This is on our Raspberry Pi. You go into a program, I'm using WinSCP to tunnel into my Raspberry Pi. And what we're looking for is this metrics.js file. If you double click it, it'll open an editor and you will get this file here opened up, JavaScript of course. I am adding in these lines here for the DIY playground device. I'm telling it for the light level. I'm looking for an expression or data that comes to the Raspberry Pi over the Moteino USB with the category 9905. And then I'm actually going to send it a number 0 through, let's say, 1023 for the relative light it's measuring in the room through the photoresistor. And I'm calling the units of measured level simply. You'll see that on the gateway display shortly. And then for the external LED, I actually have two lines of code here. The LED off status, when I see the data 9900 come through with a colon and then a zero, I'm trying to tell the gateway that I have a status of off. I do that after it's issued the command to turn it off, so it's either turned off or turned on. And then conversely, you have this LED on line. It has to be a separate name for the JavaScript to work right. And you call that LED status again, but you change the values to on. Again, you can see 9900 is the category, then the value is number 1. The other piece of code that you need to put into this file is a little further down. It's in the area of the default Mote definitions. So this is the Mote definition file that enables the buttons that I'm going to show that will control the external LED. And when it's going on or off, it goes through these different types of buttons. You can set button color. You can tell the button whether to show up or not, conditionally or unconditionally, depending on what the status is of the LED currently. And I'll demonstrate all of that next in the example. Before we run our demonstration, here's just an overview of what the final thing looks like on the breadboard. You've got your Moteino hooked up, and then on the breadboard you'll take your photoresistor, hook that to pins A2 and A5 like so, and then you'll hook a resistor 220 ohms from the A5 to the ground pin like so, and then another 220 ohm resistor over here to your LED, and the other leg of the LED goes to digital pin 3. We have our gateway dashboard pulled up now on our computer with the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. You can see it's already detected automatically here at the bottom. Number 121 is the gateway node ID number, but it doesn't know what it is yet. So in order to define that, you just click on that area and you have to select the type. Now you can see there's a John's DIY example in the drop-down list. You can put a little description in here, like if you want node 121 example, hit tab and then go back home. And you'll see it pop up here. If it's big like that with the icon, if you hit F5 to refresh, it'll make it small again, and then it actually categorizes it in the list. So you can see it's receiving data. It tells you how often it's last received an update. So it was 11 seconds ago, now 14. If I click on it now, I can see that it has a light level of 14. I'll take a flashlight right now, and I'll put that on the photoresistor. You can't see me doing this, but I got the light on there now. It's going to update every 30 seconds, so there it just jumped to 435, the value. So that's working well. You can also check on status of things. If you take a look at the control panel here, you can actually send it commands. For example, if I want to tell node number 121 to turn the LED on, it's LON is what I'm using as my command. I hit the send button, and it'll send that command over, and we can see if it did it. I can look at my Moteino and see that the LED is on now. Actually, and that popped up the button, and you can see the LED status has now been commanded to on, and we're recording that. If I hit this button here, it's sending the command to turn the LED off. It takes it some time before it sends the command if it's waiting on other things or doing other things, but it'll send it. When it actually does do it, it acknowledges the message and it'll actually change the status by itself, and then it changes the button from off to on. So in short, that's how this thing works. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I'd be happy to answer them for you. And I hope you liked it. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. And please subscribe for future videos. This is John from John's DIY Playground. Have a great day.